Hello, and welcome to Maths with Jay. If you're going to be using your calculator to do mathematics, then you'll probably want to set it up so that it's working in math mode. So let's have a look at how to do that. Press the Shift key first of all, so you can see the S appearing on the display. Then the Setup key. And to get into math mode, just key in 1. And then you will see math appear on the display. And that will stay like that when you switch the calculator off and switch it back on again. It will still be in math mode unless you want to change it back again, and you'd have to go through a setup routine again to change that. So the advantage of having your calculator in math mode is that you can get answers in fractions, and you can also work in terms of, for example, pi, which can be very useful if you want to, say, find the area of a circle or the circumference of a circle, and you want to leave the answer in terms of pi. Later on, as you do more advanced work, you may want to work with the letter E, so you can get answers in terms of E. And also, this calculator will work in terms of certs. So if you're doing advanced mathematics, it can be much more accurate to get an answer, for example, in terms of root 2, instead of a decimal that goes on forever in an unpredictable kind of way. So for example, if I key in the square root of 8, once my calculator's in math mode, and do equals, instead of giving me the answer as a decimal, we'll get 2 root 2. But if we want the answer as a decimal, we use this little key here, which will convert from standard to decimal or back again. So if we use this key, it will give us the decimal value of root 8. And we hit it again to go back to the 2 root 2. The same sort of thing will happen to fractions. So if, for example, we key in 3/4 and just do equals, that would stay as 3/4. But if we press the SD key, then it will give us the fraction as a decimal. So a very useful thing to do to have your calculator in math mode.